Petra!
Oh boy. Additional tasks. Okay. Okay, not go there then. Okay. Gotta do the additional tasks first. Where's my brother? I wanna be able to go see my brother, but I don't think I can. I don't know. Well, I guess I gotta check the map, I guess. I don't know. Is there a map currently here? Not very much of a map. Addison. Kesh. Okay, we'll go talk to Addison. Who are you? You should maybe get a chair. Wow, you are green! I did not realize Turians could be green. And this desk was not made for somebody of your height.
This is Nexus Control to Hyperion.
What choice do we have? How the hell should I know?
Excellent. Let's go
over
the document.
You have a job. If you want to keep it, do it.
Huh?
God damn it.
What? There was like three conversations going on.
All right, what happened?
To who?
To whom? And your goddamn father. Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with.
Don't speak to me like that!
And
jeez,
right now,
this is my dad!
I want to know what happened with Alec. Not how he died. I pulled those logs. What happened with Pathfinder?
What?
In the moment, it saved my life. But it seems my father meant for me to get the role, eventually.
It isn't hereditary. If we wanted an inbred monarchy, we could have left half our gene stock back home. Not home. The Milky Way. This is home. This mess. We don't have a lot of options, Ryder. Maybe you'll prove your father right. After 14 months of failed colonization, forgive me if I don't hold my breath.
Oh boy!
You called my father Alec. No one does that.
A lot of us joined the initiative because of his vision. What he shared of it, anyway.
Were you friends, or...?
I'm not your new mother, if that's what you're asking. Or his friend. He hated that I didn't use his title. But no one's a pathfinder until they've path-found something. Much like a colonial director without colonies.
Okay.
How do you fit into the Nexus leadership?
I oversee the actual settlement effort. As the number of outposts is currently less than ideal, my influence is limited. As Tan is quick to remind me. Left a perfectly adequate career as a chief officer. Provincial capital, too. Only a new galaxy could pull me away.
Oh, her mouth is still glowing.
And here we are, idling.
There must be some kind of plan for encountering hostile aliens. We can't have been that naive.
We expected life, not an enemy that refuses to talk. They don't attack. They disinfect. We're nothing until we're bacteria. Sorry, 14 months and you stoop to poetry. That's how bad it is.
That was horrible poetry, though.
Not sure who started it, but we're calling them Ket. Kandros will know more. Maybe too much.
You don't trust him?
I trust him to defend us. I do not trust a rising military influence in a supposedly civilian initiative. We came here to make history, Ryder. Not repeat it. Ugh. Goddamn poetry.
You've had no colony successes in over a year? How many tries is that?
Less than you'd think. The scourge, spoiled worlds, exiles, hostiles. We can't just plop down an outpost and expect picket fences. We need the Pathfinder and Sam to scout, evaluate, and inspire. The initiative promised a goal. Andromeda has not cooperated.
And if it had?
Beautiful utopian horseshit. Colonies that produce and support each other. The Nexus as Citadel, not headed by Tan, or even me.
There's also this strange technology. Has anyone studied that?
We've tried. Not me. The brains in research. They're supposed to know their business. The current excuse? The tech we dug up on Mars was more advanced, but it was plug and go. The tech here thinks different? I don't know. We've mostly avoided it. And from what the Hyperion logs say about Alec, maybe that's good.
Excuse me, Director Addison.
Ryder?
It's Pathfinder.
Ryder, we're starving here. If we don't get a foundation of outposts to feed the initiative, we might as well be 600 years dead. Alec promised a lot. None of it panned out. That's what you're up against. Why people won't trust you. Why I don't trust you.
You're not gonna trust me right off the bat? What? No, that's not how it works! You're a jerk. I don't like you. You don't gotta be mean. Woo!
Tempest crew should report to the docking area at once.
You don't gotta be
Hello,
mean.
Hello, console. You and I are going to be very good friends. We'll get you all fixed up and ready to go in no time. As soon as we hook you up to all that juicy, juicy power.
All right there, buddy. You have been alone for way too long. Oh, so down here. I'm in Colonial Affairs. Let's go over here. Wait, let's make sure. Who are you? Tan? I don't want to talk to Tan yet, right? I want to speak with Chandra. Ooh, who's over here? Oh, Kesh. She was over there. Alright, well, let's go back. I don't want to go to Tan's office yet. I am loving the environment!
Please await further instructions.
Girl Scout cookies. What? Wait, really? Seriously, I want those. Yeah! Yo! Hi, Mom.
Yes, I know the Hyperion docking unannounced caused some switches to blow. That's fine. I don't care. We know the problem is more widespread than we thought. We're working to fix it. That's all.
Okay.
There you are. Hope the others haven't been giving you a hard time. There's a lot that needs doing. At least with the Hyperion hooked up and feeding us power, my team and I can get more work done.
Do you guys still have the genophage?
I noticed there aren't a lot of Krogan around.
You haven't spoken to Number 8 yet, have you?
Huh?
Number 8?
Tan. Ask him why most of my people left. He'll have a
convince.
I can tell you this much. When the mutiny happened, a deal was made. My clan were supposed to settle matters and, in return, get more say in the initiative.
Oh. I suppose that makes sense, right? Yikes.
Why do you call Tan 8?
Because he was 8th in line to take over the Andromeda initiative. I like to remind him of that now and then. Keep him humble.
So, is that lady dead? Where's the lady who was in charge of all this? Did everybody die who wanted to be here?
Did the deal go through?
The clan held up their part, but Tan had a meltdown when he found out we wanted more say around here. Then Addison's assistant, Spender, pretended he never made the deal in the first place. It was a mess, but I don't blame my people for walking out. We're done being used.
Yeah, I don't blame them at all. That was really unfair.
With your clan gone, why did you stay?
It's complicated. The station and my clan both need me here.
Okay. We could ask about it!
When we left the Milky Way, the Krogan were still dealing with a genophage.
Right. The genophage. A little gift to our people from the Solarians thousands of years ago. That sterility virus they infected us with left most of our children stillborn. Only 1 in 1,000 survive.
What about the Krogan here in Andromeda?
There's no cure for it. But my clan was starting to
that's right!
A natural
that they were
defense.
Starting to develop a natural
During the trip
immunity.
To get here, Krogan underwent gene therapies to enhance the mutation while we were in
stasis.
So you used those 600 years to your advantage. Gave the adaptation more time to develop.
Yeah. It's still early, but I think we made a dent. Our scientists say we've improved viability to almost 4%, which is a lot better than what we had.
Okay.
Beyond all the statistics, it means more Krogan children will live. It's the only way my people have a future out here.
Dang. Nice.
No wonder your people have such a problem with Solarians.
Some wounds never heal. Not that my ancestors didn't provoke it. They did try to conquer the galaxy. The Solarians were forced to respond. And it's not fair to blame it all on them, either. The Solarians developed the virus, but it was the Turians who deployed it. I'm hoping that's all in the past. Plenty of blame to go around, but Andromeda is about new beginnings. My people need that more than most.
Mm, indeed.
What sort of problems have you seen on the Nexus?
Situation's gone to shit. Sums it up. There's arcs missing. Some idiots tried to mutiny and take over, then more idiots offended my clan, so they left. And to top it all off, the founder of the Initiative,
Why? How is she killed? What do you mean she was killed?
What happened to Jean Garson?
Killed in the Scourge disaster. Her and a bunch of the other leaders. Tan might know more.
How? Why?
And I thought the Hyperion had it bad when we arrived. Anything else?
The outposts aren't happening because we don't have resources or people, so Addison's more uptight than ever. And let's not forget how badly the station was damaged on arrival. But that's a detail, according to some. My team and I are repairing what we can. If we don't get materials soon, things will go downhill. Fast.
Jeez. So much!
What kind of work do you do as superintendent?
I was part of the team that originally designed and built this place.
Wow!
I keep the station functional, or as functional as possible, considering.
All right.
Nothing more for now.
Bye, Mom.
Good luck out there.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you already. I don't love having to pick up crap. I don't. I don't want to have to deal with it. Kandros, where you at, buddy? Apparently, he's got a plus one Solarian magnifier. What does that mean? Are you sure? That's a good idea?
Tempest crew should report to the docking area.
Arms merchant? Yo, buddy.
Weapons and stuff. I got you covered. Use the console to take a look through what
you
I got.
You are creeping me out.
It'd be a lot easier if I weren't missing half my stock.
Ouch. Why am I paying for these?
Half the supplies are inaccessible, what with how we crash-landed and all. And I have to trade with the crooks out there for the rest, so...
What? Let me out. What? Can I have it? Ultra rare shotgun. Oh, it's a second Omniblade, right? Ew. Tempting. Operations? Oh, shoot. During his absence. Sloan Kelly, I recognize that name. Okay. 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 Did you go out yourself? Oh no, that was from the recon team. Okay, I was like, I don't know about that, buddy. Sorry. The new Asari design is interesting. I saw that. You slid right over.
But the planet was toxic. What if they store oxygen in porous tissue, like Quiro's rockfish?
I still reckon they had breather gear stowed in that armor.
Perhaps both. Life is infinitely adaptable, as our expedition proves.
Let me speak to you.
You must be the Pathfinder. Wonderful. You and your Sam are exactly what we need.
Cute hat, bro.
Thanks, Mr.
Professor Heerick, my colleagues and I will work with your Sam and the data you gather to solve Andromeda's scientific mysteries.
I'm usually out in the field, but I wouldn't mind talking shop, or lab, you know.
You are always welcome.
Not that you've had much to study with everyone cooped up for 14 months.
But your data on the Scourge flows like poetry. Now we can better advise on repairing the damage it caused.
And maybe Addison will give us a real workspace. Who can think with all this racket?
Okay.
Pathfinder, we've had some trouble.
Anything I can help with?
Perhaps. I discharged an away team to get readings from a section of the Scourge that was behaving anomalously. They haven't reported in for some time, and sensors can't locate their shuttle. I sent them out there. Good, dedicated people. I fear what might have happened to them.
Don't give up hope. When I'm out there, I'll see if I can find them.
Their friends and family will want to know what's happened, and I need to know.
Okay. Hi, guy.
Hi, Pathfinder. Want to hit some rocks for science?
Yes!
Absolutely. What do you need?
Sam and I used your scans and made a VI for geophysics surveys. Beta build's on the console there. Test it out in the field, and I'll wrangle you a consultant's bonus from Director Addison. How's that sound?
Why do we even need money in this economy? What? Which one? Which terminal? Give me... Gimme.
Tram technicians, please report to the Hyperion coupling annex.
But what happened to the other arcs, Where are the Quarians at, Where are the Asari and the Solarians and... Activate! Ha! Tune voice recognition to recognize both aluminum and aluminum. Wait, no. Aluminium and aluminum. Okay. Haptic interface not found. Customized SAM handshake protocols. Gimme. Woo! You guys weren't on my list, but I'm glad I looked at you. Are you a Turian? You got some crazy outfits on. You guys still have nice trees, though. Liam!
Notice the handoff there. Too small for lizards.
You'd be surprised. There's also Pervine in the seed bank.
Nobody's making Creeper in Andromeda.
You'd be surprised.
This is a nightmare.
Huh?
Pathfinder, no time for our beer yet. This place is a mess. Security is it. Let's call it strained.
I can believe it. Nexus is running on empty.
Not just that. A lot of the exiles were security. Everyone was trained and armed.
Why? Why did they all take off?
We know they are dangerous, and now we have to worry about our people too. No idea where they went, but they left mad.
Why?
They were frustrated. If they just wanted to kill, they could have fought to the last here.
Apparently we're the big hope for everyone. Not the Hyperion showing. Just us. I'm with you. It's just... a lot.
This wasn't in the job description. We have to find a world, then save it.
Glad it's not just me feeling it. But it's not just you either. We're a team, right? It's what they need us to be.
Okie dokie, where's the distraught Turian? Are you a distraught Turian? I will help you.
It's not right. It's not fair.
You look awesome.
What's wrong?
Oh my, you're... So it's true. A Pathfinder has found us. There's hope
at last. I saw that, Kandros.
Maybe you could help. You're impartial. This whole thing has gotten so political. My husband, he's locked up and slated for exile for a crime he didn't commit.
Exile, huh? Guess it wasn't for having a hand in the cookie jar.
They say it's murder. They're calling him the first murderer in Andromeda, but the dead man was his friend. He wouldn't have... There are witnesses and evidence, but it's all circumstantial. At worst, it was an accident. His name is Nilkin Rensis. He could give you the details if you were willing to speak with him. Please.
Of course.
I'd be happy to.
Oh, thank you. I'm sure the jailer will allow you a visit. Please, tell Nilkin I love him.
Jeez.
Tempest crew should report to the docking area.
Tempest crew! I heard that! Gimme, gimme! Gimme my ship! Well, that decent recon and greater intel on the enemy. We need to scale down expectations again. Okay, well, I'm here now, apparently. That just, blah.
I know that look. The others bent your ear, did they?
Something like that?
You get used to it. Just focus on being a Pathfinder. Can't argue with results, though they'll try. Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Tyrian Ark.
What's the word on the Tyrian Ark?
Scattered readings.
Are you frozen?
Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
I was tired of being the good one.
The good one?
The Kandros family is old military. There were expectations.
Ah,
you know?
Yeah, I feel you.
Then my sister became a sculptor, and cousin Nyrene went pirate on Omega.
Nyrene!
That I stayed in
I
service.
Think I know. Yeah, yeah, that, yeah, yeah!
When do I get my adventure? Jen Garson's dream was so grand, so gutsy, I had to be part of it.
Nyrene is I haven't played it yet, but she's in the Omega DLC.
You talk like you weren't part of the leadership. How did you end up commanding the militia?
I was escorting a prospecting team on some moon when those Ket found us. They penned us like cattle for experiments. I managed to get loose, snatched a gun, and freed the others. By the time we killed the bastards and headed back to warn the Nexus, everyone looked at me like I was in charge.
That sounds familiar.
Eh.
The militia grew from there. Funny, once the heat is on, all kinds of people rise to the top.
Ha ha.
Are the other Turians managing okay?
So-so. We're not good at sitting around in a crisis. Service before self gets drummed into us at boot camp. That's probably why so many of us are in the militia. We like to earn our citizenship, whatever galaxy we're in. But it's hard to focus with our arc missing.
It's rough out there. I might need backup if you can spare the people.
I have strike teams specializing in assault and extraction. If you need serious firepower, my Apex teams have you covered. In fact, I could give you authority to dispatch them. It'll cut down their response time.
Well, geez, thanks.
Thank you.
Our current ops are on the terminal. See if there's anything that could use a shot where it counts.
I think that's where the multiplayer ties in.
What do you know about the enemies we've encountered? The Ket.
We usually see them on worlds with those alien structures. The Ket don't take kindly to anyone studying them. Not sure why. They don't talk to us. Every time we cross paths, there's a fight or they take prisoners.
Why? What do they want?
No one knows. But I've seen their weaponry and what they do to those prisoners. I want them a long, long way from the Nexus.
Okay.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Okay, bye. I'm not gonna worry about that because I don't care right now. I want my ship! Oh, pretty. That guy must have the patience of a saint. Oops.
This is the planet where we landed. Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
That's been true of every world we've found. Ryder, we were discussing your next expedition.
I thought I didn't measure up as Pathfinder.
Director Addison keeps her own counsel. I keep mine.
And when you disagree?
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself. To that end, the Scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it is, our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
It wasn't here when we left the Milky Way, yet it rendered all the Golden Worlds unlivable.
Huh.
And there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are six worlds.
So all new ones, okay.
Okay, but you said every planet you found is unlivable, so how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Right. I think I should go check on things. And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Cora just abandoned me!
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
I look angry.
The way I see it, you need me. If I pull this off, maybe you'll look like the leader you pretend to be.
But first, you have to succeed at being the Pathfinder you pretend to be.
Touché!
Where's my ship?
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for Eos will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
I was wondering about
that. Sam?
Something wrong?
Ryder, please see me and Samnude on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
No. I'm fine.
Ryder, you may have a less than flattering view of me, but I want to express my condolences for your father.
I appreciate it.
I didn't know him very well, although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned that we still have several arcs missing.
They're as much a part of the initiative as the human arc. We'll find them.
We have to. Tens of thousands of colonists are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative in an unflattering light. Did you have some other business?
As director of the initiative, are you in charge around here, or what?
If the others would allow me, they don't see me as the rightful successor.
What's their problem with you?
I am not Gian Garson. Our founder was charismatic, eccentric, larger than life. Traits I cannot hope to mimic. She and her inner circle perished in the Scourge, some at the hands of the Exiles. Some never made it out of stasis. I was deputy assistant for revenue management. Then all seven leaders above me died. I was next in line for the role.
Yeah, what?
So, you're an accountant?
Don't let that fool you. We are all capable of more than we know. When I was young, I was fascinated by the idea of exploring space. Life had its detours, and I went a different direction. Then I heard about the initiative. And saw my chance to try the path not taken. While I may not be setting foot on new worlds, my authority can ensure that you do.
Right. Sorry. So how does anything get done?
In theory, Kesh handles the Nexus's physical operations, Kandros runs the militia, and Addison manages colonial affairs. I oversee all of it. In practice, we argue, debate, and yell at each other until a decision is made. If we're lucky. It is maddening.
It is maddening. That was very well done.
What more can you tell me about the initiative?
It represents the greatest migration ever attempted. No one had ventured beyond the Milky Way before. We've all left home in search of freedom, fortune, perhaps a new beginning. We are the bravest souls each species has to offer. I hope the Nexus will serve as the seat of government for us all.
Jeez.
What do you know about the early days of the initiative?
As most everyone knows, Gian Garson's vision made it happen. She was an entrepreneur on Earth. Wealthy. Young for a human. Garson had the idea for the initiative in the early 2170s, I believe. Many thought leaving the Milky Way was impossible. But she persevered. And as with most great ideas, the doubters were wrong.
Why do you think most people came?
There are thousands of reasons, one for every colonist here. What does any pilgrim seek? Usually, happiness. Finding the thing that eludes them, the thing to fulfill them. While we cannot promise they will find it, We can facilitate
the search. He doesn't seem like a bad dude. He seems like he's probably a pretty good leader, you know? Maybe a bit, manipulative, but, I mean, any good leader is, you know?
It looks like a melting pot around here.
The Nexus is home to several initiative species. Many came ahead of the Arcs. The hope is that this station will one day serve as the governing body in Andromeda. Though I'm not sure what they were thinking, lumping Krogan into the
mix. Don't start with me, boy!
As a Solarian, my kind tend to have a low opinion of them. Nothing I've seen here has changed that.
Why don't you like the Krogan?
It's common knowledge that they are a violent, ignorant species. Long ago, they waged nuclear war on one another. Their planet was decimated. My people tried to uplift them.
You uplifted them because they were violent. That...
What if they bring their tempers to Andromeda? We'll all be dead.
No, we won't.
Sounds like the Nexus has had a rough time of it.
Publicly, I would say we're more than up for the challenge. Privately, I can tell you, it's been a disaster. The Scourge killed hundreds. Many of them our senior leadership.
How did it kill the senior leadership?
Founder of the initiative, Jean Garson, is dead.
How did Jean Garson die?
With the rest of the leadership. When the Nexus hit the Scourge, a large wing of stasis pods was destroyed. They were killed instantly. These people traveled 600 years and died before they even woke up. Jean Garson never glimpsed Helios.
That's really sad.
She never saw her vision
like,
realized.
Wow, like, the leader, like... Okay, wait a second. Let's pick it back up a second and say, oh my gosh, that really sucks. Like, to be understatement. Like, this... Wow, it's like just hitting me now. Like, the woman who made all of this possible, the one who gave us all those briefings and stuff, she never got to see the Helios cluster? Why? Like, I'm a little bit... I understand, like... we're losing all the leadership everywhere, and now we have to make up our own and deal with whatever. But that seems a bit harsh.
Kandros mentioned something about hitting the Scourge. How did it play out?
Criminal elements took advantage of the emergency and preyed on people's
fears. Like, immediately?
An uprising followed. We had no choice but to turn to the Krogan to deal with them. They crushed the mutiny, and the criminals were banished. Exiles, we called them. I doubt we've heard the last of them. They're led by an outlaw, Sloane Kelly. She used to be one of ours.
Who is this Sloane Kelly?
She was head of security on the Nexus. She opposed the uprising at first, but eventually turned traitor and joined them. Misguided sympathy for the plight of the common citizen? Nonsense. They posed a direct threat to our existence.
There don't seem to be many Krogan around.
Good riddance.
Shut up, man!
The Krogan demanded a greater say in political matters. The last place you want them involved.
No wonder they're not idiots! You treated them like animals!
Lifting heavy objects. When they didn't get what they wanted, they left.
You're a jerk.
What do I need to consider in making a planet viable?
Assuming the planet supports life, an outpost is critical. People like a roof over their heads, and you'll want to eliminate any hostile threats. Whether that's the cat or other terrors lurking in Helios, colonists being murdered on site can be discouraging.
Yeah.
Also, scouting and mapping terrain is a priority for any Pathfinder. And don't forget forward stations. You'll want those.
What can you tell me about forward stations?
What can you tell me about?
I was afraid you'd ask.
It's
mostly what the engineers tell me. A forward station allows mining, equipment repairs, and resupply for field teams. I mean, who wouldn't want that? But seeing as how every colonization effort has failed, it's just theory at the moment. You get to test it out, Ryder.
This guy's voice actor is a treasure. Let me just say that.
Any more information you can give me on the missing Arcs?
No, and that is the distressing part. The Asari, Turian, and Solarian Arcs are completely unaccounted for. If they had the same problems with the Scourge that we did, I fear the worst. Should you find any clues, please investigate.
Yeah,
Without the other Arcs, the promise of the Initiative can never be fulfilled.
Are there any other Arcs we should expect?
Quarian!
We had hoped Quarians would be part of the first wave. But before departure in 2185, we got word they had technical problems with their ship. It seems they're also bringing along Drell, Hanar, and other species as well. Managing all of their biological needs caused complications. We won't see them for some time to come.
You're telling me that you're gonna be holding the Drell away from me? Do we not get to see? They're gonna be part of the next game, aren't they? We're gonna have to wait another 5 years before we see any Drell or Quarians at all, aren't we? Oh, I'm so mad! They're bringing Drell! Drell! If you've not seen my Mass Effect 3 playthrough, I romanced a Drell, and it was the best thing and the worst thing that ever happened to me!
That's all. Ah!
Of course, as you pointed out, we need each other. Our futures depend on each other's success.
It's true! It's true! Alright, buddy. Alright, I probably have to call this one here. But, thank you guys. Sorry about my... not sorry. Man, we're not gonna be able to see them, are we? I am really upset. Like, even if we can't see Drell, I wanted to see Quarians. And Hanar, too. I wasn't sure if we were gonna get them. I wonder if the Volus and the Elcor are coming. Jeez. I didn't think they were going to be coming. I thought they were going to try to make all new alien species and just kind of cut us down to the basic ones, but I don't know. Or either that, or they taunt us with the idea of Quarians and Turians, or Quarians and Drell. They're like, oh, they all die because everybody dies in this game. I thought it was supposed to be more lighthearted, but everybody's dying. I'm upset. All right, but thank you guys for joining me. I appreciate it. I will see you in the next one.